Hi, Manju.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. I'm good. We are waiting to watch this very interesting film. And
yes,
the fact that it's also looking like a healing journey between the two of you. That's also something that was one of the comments. So can we start with that, saying that how is this a healing journey, this film? This series or a film, what you call it?
So making of Breakpoint was just a phenomenal experience, because both Mahesh and myself are really grateful to Ashwini Iyer Tiwari, Nitesh Tiwari, Piyush, the whole production at Earth Sky, for shooting through the last 20 months through pandemic.
Right.
Basically, we all came into a location and no one from the outside was allowed in, no one from the inside could go out. And we told a real true story. We've told it very hard, we've told it very raw, we've told you all the ups and downs of how two young boys had a dream to be Wimbledon champions and how we achieved that dream. But also we were able to tell you a story of how champions can be vulnerable. And that's the thing that I really respect about Mahesh, is that we were able to always tell the truth raw. Mm-hmm. And we didn't shy away in an era of social media, in an era of where everybody's trying to portray something that is superlatively good about themselves. Mm-hmm. Both of us can keep it real, and we don't have any problems taking it on the chin when we need to.
That's amazing, because I think that's a lot of sportsman spirit, which is off screen also, that we're talking about. And it becomes, I think it permeates into your personality in a way. So I'd like to talk about that, especially where you deal with issues that are a little uncomfortable, but you deal with them, like you said. So how was that part? How were those, you know, those knots, and how did you untie them?
I mean, we've lived real time through it, right? I mean, through the uncomfortable issues, we've continued to play for India for a decade or so. So it wasn't so complicated for us to kind of relive that in front of the camera, because we have lived it real time. So it was easier than I think a lot of people think it was.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. There's an unconditional brotherhood, which is always been what people have admired and looked at, despite personal differences, or I mean, nobody could tell. So how was it on, when you were on ground, how was that? It was only the game, there was nothing. I mean, because both of you also know each other's strengths and each other's points where you could complement each other.
That's the beautiful part about this brotherhood, Manju, is that we've known each other since we were about 15 and 16 years old, where we had the dream of winning Wimbledon and being the best in the world. Now, not only have we achieved our dreams, but also at the same time, this brotherhood has stood the test of time. We've seen each other in the highest of highs. We've seen each other in the lowest of lows. We've taken some blows. We've had some great victories. But yet we're here today telling you a story to inspire a whole generation that if Leander and Mahesh can be champions, then so can you be a champion. You just need some passion, you need hard work, and you need self-belief. Three things.
Amazing. And also the fact that you felt safe to narrate this film to a very well-known filmmaker. The fact that you could bear your soul to Nitesh and Ashwini in this manner.
Yeah, I think a lot of credit goes to them, because, Leander and me have been approached multiple times in the past to do this story. We never really took it to any conclusion. This time, when we heard Nitesh and Ashwini were open to a discussion, that their pedigree of storytelling is obviously second to none. And immediately they gave us an immense amount of comfort on how they were going to tell it, how they were going to allow us to talk independently. And because they were able to give us that comfort is why we went ahead. And, I think we're both glad that we did.
In the film, you've also relived two decades of your career. So how long did it take to, talk and get this all sorted and make this into a cinema? So they created the script and all of that. But it's two decades of a career that's been spoken about. And to crystallize it into highlights.
So it's been exactly 20 months from when collective artists Vijay Subramaniam and Ashu Naik actually brought the idea to us. 20 months ago when they first came to us and said, guys, this is a great story to tell. Mahesh and myself had fended off hundreds of offers from Bollywood and feature films and other platforms to tell our story. I think, Ash, it was 20 years we fended this off?
Yeah.
And finally, when they brought it to us, we said, listen, you know what, you can't capture this story of Leander Mahesh in a 90-minute or 120-minute feature film.
Right.
You need many different series to tell different nuances of the human emotion between right. Leander Mahesh. Because our story is a very complex story. It's a story of tremendous patriotism, a story of tremendous belief, a story of the greatest highs and some of the lowest lows.
Right.
And in that also, Manju, we haven't chosen any actors to tell this story.
Right.
We've told this story real. We've done it ourselves, which takes a lot of courage.
Yeah.
And in that, I'm really happy with the way that it's turned out.
So that's my next question. Facing the camera and talking about your innermost feelings. It could be conflict, it could be turmoil, it could be anger. All of that together. How did that happen?
Yeah, those were the negative emotions. We had a tremendous amount of positive emotions also, which a lot of people fail to kind of address because of, you know, all the success we've had and all the records we broke.
Right.
So, yeah, I mean, if you mix all those emotions into one pot, I think both of us have relived that in the last 3 months shooting this and 20 months narrating it. But, you know, it's something, like I said, we've lived through real time. So, you know, for us, it was kind of easy to do.
And the fact that, what are the do's and don'ts of a great partnership? If you can tell.
You're going to have to watch the docuseries, Manju.
Yes, of course. for a teaser, for people to know. If you're just giving me a few, if you can give me a few pointers.
Well, I'll tell you one of the do's.
Yeah.
Belief. Trust.
What would you say?
Yeah, find a partner who compliments you. And not artificially. I'm talking about on the tennis court.
Okay. What were the toughest questions to answer? I'm sure this was also a questionnaire. There could be a lot of questions thrown at you by the filmmakers and the script team. What were the toughest questions to answer?
The unscripted ones. And there were a whole lot of them. We did not actually read the script. We did not have to read the questions to be prepared. We actually did it very raw.
Mm-hmm.
And one is to do it truthfully, the other is to do it very raw, where you don't know what's coming at you.
Mm-hmm.
You don't know. We shot separately. So we were in one location, but Mahesh was shooting separately, I was shooting separately, our parents shot separately, our partners shot separately, our coaches and our opponents shot separately. I think only the Bryan twins shot together, sitting side by side. But when you actually see the different perceptions of everybody at that time that were in the story, that were living the Leander Mahesh dream. Some are really harsh, some are expected, some are very interesting because you never knew at that point. I think one of the things that Hesh and myself did well was that we lived in a bubble. When it came to playing on the tennis court, everything on the tennis court was very sacred. And nothing off the tennis court ever deterred or interfered with what was happening on the court. And like your first question asked, was that that's how actually we got the world record of 24 undefeated wins in Davis Cup. Because our sense of patriotism to play for our countrymen is so immense that no matter what our differences are, we always put our best forward for our country. And that's what we feel the proudest of.
And you've also mentioned somewhere that you would have hoped that Breakpoint would have come earlier in your life. This kind of
I don't know. I mean, I don't know how Leander feels, but I don't think so. I think if we wanted to do it earlier, we would have, right? I mean, this decision lies with us. I mean, it's our story. So, you know, if he really wanted to do it, he would have called me and said, let's put it together, or I would have done the same. But like I said, you know, the environment and the partners were not the right ones who, you know, we were approached with at that time. And, you know, this time it was. And that's why we made the effort to kind of tell the story.
Were there moments where you went back? I'm sure it's a lot of reliving your past and a lot of emotions that come with that, pulling that strand out to current life. Were there any moments where you got lost and you sort of, you had to, were there any emotional moments, I'm sure?
You're going to have to watch the series. I mean, it is, there are tons of emotions in it. There are tons of highs and lows in it. There are tons of punches pulled in it. But that's exactly what the human emotion story is about us. I mean, we are very honest about our craft on the tennis court. We've been very honest about our craft in front of a camera. And I think that's what the viewers are going to love about it, is that these are not actors acting. These are us playing ourselves. It's a true story. Okay. And it's a true life story. It's everything you're going to see is actual fact. And it's also been documented in the archival footage that actually matches up to our verbal conversation. What is unique is you get perspectives of many different other people. And that's what actually throws googlies in there, is that it wasn't just two young kids who embarked on a dream to achieve greatness, but everything that happened between us. And maybe that's what caused the differences. Maybe that's what caused a little distance between us. And we take responsibility for that. But the best thing about it is that this brotherhood is stood the test of time. And we're still here telling the story true and raw, to inspire people all over the world that they can be champions too.
Also, the fact that somewhere you mentioned that communication was key, and there was a lack of communication at a certain point in time, which is why a lot of miscommunication happened. So can you tell me about that?
Yeah, communication is always key in a successful partnership. We had lapses of communication. There's no question about that. I mean, it's easy for us to sit back and talk about it 20 years later, which we have. But, like I said, what has happened has happened. We're still Wimbledon champions. You guys are all going to hopefully watch Breakpoint and, relive the story and enjoy it. And we're very happy about that.
I have the last question. I've already been flagged. Okay. And, okay, so when you watched the series, did you watch it together? And what was that reaction of to watching together when you watched it for the first time?
We actually have been traveling, both of us, so we're in different locations right now as we speak to you. But I think Mahesh has watched it over the last 48 hours, and I've watched it over the last 48 hours, and I'm thrilled with it. I feel like it's been told so truly, so hard-hitting and cutting-edge, that even some of the archival footage, I wish I had watched that in 2000, Manju. I wish at the end of 99 and 2000, I'd watched some of episode 4, the Wimbledon episode. If I'd watched some of that back then, I could have really seen what emotions were in Mahesh's heart and his head at that point. But I didn't have the benefit then. I feel like at that time, our relationship was not at the best situation. We weren't communicating at all. And hence, we broke up in 2000, early 2000, I think. And I wish I'd watched some of that footage back then. Maybe I could have picked up the phone and said, hey, let's go for some ice cream, the morning after winning Wimbledon, and thrashed out a few conversations and thrown our arm around each other over a shawarma or some ice cream and continued playing together. But I'll take responsibility for that. I think sometimes communication is of the essence. It doesn't matter what differences you have amongst people. You celebrate those differences. That's what true friendship's about.
Great. What do you have to say? What was your reaction, Mahesh? When you watched it?
I say amen to that.
Let's see you at church tomorrow, bro.
Thank you very much for speaking to me. This is amazing. And love to watch it. And
thanks.
We post a review about it soon. Thank you.
Thanks, Manju.
Thank you. Bye.
Thank you.